Thank you, NJROTC cadets, Del Airs, and band members for getting us started. My name is Steve Gilliland. I'm the head principal at Del City High School, and I would like to welcome you to the Class of 2023 Commencement Program. Just one final thing before we get started, I would ask that you please silence your cell phones. At this time, may I present to you Latrell Crump, president of the senior class.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. I just want to say a special thank you to everyone who is here in attendance today for the celebration of the end and a new beginning of a new chapter for these young and great individuals here in front of us all today. I am Latrell Crump, and I am the senior class president. Look, Class of 2023 has been through a lot of things together and individually. We've been through all kinds of battles together and alone. But my friends, I want to say, we have never been truly alone. We all have each other. This class is important to one another. If you ever need anything, we got you. No questions asked. These last 12 years of school have been rough, filled with ups and downs we've all had to overcome. No matter if it's the loss of something or someone important, no matter if it's something we gain in a negative or a positive light, we had to and we did overcome these battles. The past 4 years alone taught us as a collective to not take what we have here for granted. Because one day, we'll look up and it's gone. And we can't get those things back. Like memories and people dear to us. I encourage you all to make the most out of the rest of these years. Because when we walk outside of this building today, we will have officially started our new chapter. And I have faith that we will all be successful and achieve every goal and milestone that we have for ourselves. And if we come to the point of despair, I want y'all to remember this line that my mother always told me. That is, this is just one moment in time. Let that sink in a bit. Which means you mope and cry about whatever took you out of your mindset. But remember, it's all just a moment. So keep going, keep pushing. The only person that can truly hold you back is yourself. And me personally, I wouldn't take that. You must believe in yourself. Believe in your ability to get whatever done. You are all strong, way stronger than you may think. I've seen some of you go through the worst things ever. But the reason I say you kept pushing is because I'm seeing y'all here today, and in the next couple minutes, finna walk this stage with the rest of our class. And I'm happy to say you are all special, and I refuse to believe that y'all will be great in succeeding this life. We are finna go deep into this world. Just know, don't go head first. This life in adulting seems hard and stressful, so let's just take one step at a time. Show the world we come and we ready. Class of 2023, DC, thank you. And I'm honored to be your senior class president. And saying 23 has been a long run, but back to square one. Go be great and make yourself proud. Thank you. So now, I have the honor of passing along the torch, well in this case, the golden eagle to Liliana Reese, the senior class president. She'll do great. Before I walk off, I would like to present our head principal, Steve Gilliland, with our senior gift. I got one more thing to say before I get on the stage. Y'all thought I was going to leave what I said? Okay. That's all I got to say. DC Eagles. Stay hard all the time. Eagles keep it crunk when the game is on the line. Ain't no Eagles like the Eagles on my side. Cause them Eagles keep it crunk. Yeah, them Eagles keep it crunk. I said, go DC, go DC, go. Go DC, go DC, go.
Go DC, go DC, go.
Let me get out of the stage, man.
The recipient of this award is chosen for their tireless effort in leadership and scholarship at Del City High School, as well as service in the Del City community. This year, we are able to give 2 scholarships, thanks to the generosity from the faculty versus student games. The first recipient of the $500 scholarship is Nabrale Mansky.
And I'm Philip Crawford, Senior Assistant Principal at Del City High School, and I just want to welcome everyone here today. It's my pleasure and honor to be able to introduce and recognize some of our guests here today, here on the platform. First, I'd like to introduce our School Board President, Dr. Sylvia Kirk. Our School Board of Education Vice President, Dr. Ed Daniel. Board of Education Clerk, Mr. Leroy Porter. Board of Education Member, Mr. Julian Biggers. And Board of Education Member, Ms. Gina Standridge. I would also like to introduce our administrators from the central office. We have Dr. Rick Cobb, Superintendent of Middell Public Schools. Dr. LaShonda Broyles, Assistant Superintendent of Instruction. We have Ms. Becky Foster, Assistant Superintendent of the Middell Tech Center. Ms. Lacey Brown, Executive Director of Teaching and Learning. Mr. Mike Bryant, Executive Director of Operations. We also have Ms. Andrea Gilkey. She's currently the Director of Alternate and Virtual Academy, but will soon be the Executive Director of Secondary Instruction. Ms. Leslie Pope, Executive Director of Elementary Instruction. Ms. Erin Rennick White, Executive Director of Technology. Ms. Tressa Wilson, Executive Director of Special Services and Advanced Learning. Ms. Jacqueline Woodard, Chief Financial Officer. Ms. Megan Bryant, Director of Counseling and Mental Health. Mr. Andy Collier, Director of Student Activities. Ms. Heather Graham, Director of Diversity, Equity, and Inclusion. Ms. Carrie Noonan, Director of Student Accounting. And Ms. Diana Williams, the Fine Arts Instructional Facilitator. And then we also have a special guest, Dr. Kevin Hill, retiring principal. I'd also like to introduce our Del City High School administration, our head principal, Mr. Steve Gilliland. Our
junior assistant principal, Ms. Courtney Riley. Our sophomore assistant principal, Ms. Christina Mitchell. And our freshman assistant principal, Mr. Corey Russell. I'd also like to recognize our counselors, Ms. Terry Craig, Ms. Lee Neely, Ms. Shelby White, and Ms. Dana Watson. And then obviously, I'd also like to thank and recognize the teachers and faculty at Bell City High School. If you guys would please stand and be recognized. Today, I also have the privilege, we're kind of starting a new tradition here, to introduce our very first Honorary Eagle. The Honorary Eagle Award is intended to recognize a person who has impacted the lives of our Del City High School graduates. As part of this recognition, this person will wear a white robe during the graduation ceremony that has been signed by members of the graduating class. This year's Honorary Eagle has been a mainstay in the Middell community for numerous years and has impacted the lives of literally generations of Middell students and community members. He is a product of Middell Schools, graduating from Del City High School in 1981, and received a full athletic scholarship to attend Southeastern University in Durant, Oklahoma. After graduating from Southeastern in 1985 with a bachelor's degree in education, he attained a teaching position within Middell Public Schools. He was hired as a PE teacher and coach at Everly Heights Elementary in the fall of 1986. During his tenure, he was twice recognized as a Building Teacher of the Year and was selected as a Middell District of the Year and a state finalist for Teacher of the Year in 1993. He went on to earn a master's degree in school administration from UCO in 1995, and for the next 5 years, he worked throughout the district as assistant principal. In 2005, he was named the head principal of Everly Heights Elementary School, and he now lays claim as the longest-serving administrator in the history of Everly Heights. This year, he will be retiring from his administrative position after 37 years in education. In addition to his career in education, our Honorary Eagle answered the call to serve in the military, and he joined the Oklahoma National Guard in 1997, serving domestically and around the world, receiving numerous awards and recognitions. He will be retiring this May with the rank of Senior Master Sergeant after serving for 25 years. Many of you may know him as a coach, as Mr., as Principal, as Master Sergeant, or even Pastor. But today I have the pleasure of introducing him as a DCH Class of 2023 Honorary Eagle, Dr. Kevin Hill.
What's up, DC Nation? Come on, let's get a little cranked up. I like that. Go, DC, go, DC, go. Don't let me down, I'm old, but I still can get down with you, okay? So let's do it. Go, DC, go, DC, go.
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 Come on, say ho.
Ho.
Say ho, ho.
Ho, ho.
Y'all still cool as we was in 81, baby. Y'all still just as cool. I'm seeing some cool dudes out there like, I didn't think that old dude would be that cool. Yes, I am. Guys, 42 years ago, I sat out there with you. So I'm like you. I'm like you. First thing we're going to do, I want the people out here, several thousand people. Man, I heard how loud you guys were when they were coming in. Can we honor the young people, all of them? Your person, can we give a round of applause to these people? We all up in here. Can we give a louder than that? This is why I'm here. This is why you're here. You know, there's a young person that came here, probably drove themselves, and don't have a big crowd. And this is not even on my speech. I want to congratulate that young person that's here. You might not have the loud grandma or somebody like that. I want to cheer for you. Can we say good job to them? Yeah. Young lady said, me, I'm the one. Can I get a little love when you call my name? I love you and I'm proud of you. Those kids that went to Everly Heights, you know who you are. Remember in the cafeteria in fifth grade, I was talking about heading graduate high school. Latrell was one of them. This is what I was talking about. Jay was another one that seemed so long ago. Congratulations to you. Congratulations to all you young people. Yeah, I'm so proud of you. 42 years ago, I said, just like this, I don't even remember what the man said. But y'all need to remember at least one thing I say. We got phones, I got something happening afterwards, but you really need to, because in 42 years, I can share some wisdom. You can take it or leave it, but I will take it. Amen. I would say, let me grab onto something that this man has said. So we're going to get started. 42 years ago, I was out there with you, and I was like, I had some questions. And I want y'all to think, because I'm looking at you, you're looking at me real good. I had some questions about the next few years. Will I go to college and graduate? What career choice will I make? Who will I marry? You better watch out, because I sat next to my girlfriend, and that's who I married. What? Better watch out. But I'll get back with that in a little bit. Will we have children? This is what I was thinking. I just turned 18 on May 12th, and it was like right now. I was like, man, I feel too young to be doing this. But it's real. Will I get to explore all the parts of the world? Man, this is, I love D.C., but I knew the world was bigger than just D.C., man. Will I get to see other parts? Will I have grandchildren? I know I'm talking down the road, but will I live long enough to have grandchildren? And will I retire one day? Man, that's some forward thinking, isn't it? That's some forward thinking, but I thought that as I sat out there. I wrote up an acrostic, which is, I'm going to spell out the word eagle. And when I say the first letter, I want y'all to be engaged with me and say, like this first one, E, and then you say E. All right, now we're going back to first grade, y'all, okay? I say E, you say E. E!
E.
I'm going to spell out eagle, so y'all go with me. Now, I was told by your teachers, man, this is an amazing hype group. Man, I like that hypeness, man. So be hype for yourself. Yeah, be hype for yourself. E is education. Okay, y'all caught me off guard on that one. We're going to do it together. And y'all can join us up there. E is for education. Man, you're going to get sick of hearing this, but it's real talk. Real talk. You got to get more one way or the other. College, career tech, military, or some other type of certification. Man, you've done great, but just stop it with the high school diploma. You got to get more. The amount of money you make, and I know y'all want to make them stacks, right? Making them stacks. Man, I'm doing some cool talking. Y'all ain't with me here. Yeah, I talk to young people. Man, he got them stacks. He got that gold chain. Yeah, I got some stacks. I work every day. Up until, a few weeks from now. The amount of money you make and the opportunities you have to advance in the future is directly related to the education level you have. So after today, we have some time to enjoy it. We got to think about that next level. You got to. A. Anticipate your next move. Anticipate your next move in life. You kind of heard my background. He started out as this, and then he became that, and then he became this. Man, I'm not trying to brag, but that's what you got to do. I love being a PE teacher, but I wouldn't go be a PE teacher my whole life. I felt a calling to move on and do some other things, so I went back to school. So A is anticipate. Don't get stagnant. Young people, listen, don't get stagnant. That's where your discouragement comes up. Keep striving to soar like an eagle above your current circumstance. That's what Latrell was saying. Tough days are going to come. We've all had them, but go above. G. Don't go to sleep on me. G. Set goals in life. Have y'all heard that one before? I'm going to ask for just some participation. Has your parents, grandparents, friends, family talk to you about goals? Just hold your hand up. Yeah, y'all, this isn't time to be shame or embarrassed. Oh, my gosh. Yeah. Don't be too cool for me now. Because this is real talk right here. Setting goals, short and long term. Short goals. What am I going to do tomorrow? What am I going to do about a job and school? This is real stuff. This has been one of my keys to life success. You can't let everyone know your dream. Now, if I can get a couple of ladies in the crowd with older people who might know what I'm talking about, now I'm telling you, man, I told my dream to a couple of so-called friends, and they were the first ones who shot me down. So that friend that is so close to you, man, I say, ask God if that is your real friend. The friend I said I was going to college, man, oh, man, that's word, dude, college. Glad I went, he didn't. Yeah. Heard one clap, it's all good. I'm glad I didn't. Watch it. Sometimes people like you just to stay low with them. You find yourself rising up, those friends start scattering. So just as you see, you will experience it. I can guarantee you. Use that to motivate you and not deter you from being great. L. We're getting your L. Like this one guy on the third row, you saying it loud, thank you. Love those in your village. That's these folks right here. Can y'all show them some love? Can the graduates show these people some love for loving you? You know, if I had a grandchild out there, I would just look right at them and say, you need to be really shouting. All you put us through, all these 17, 18 years. I know I can't be the only one in my family that have had people who've been challenging, who's needed some love. That's how you really need to thank these people who have shown up. I see these people in all the yellow, wherever people, somebody bought t-shirts and stuff. Continue to show love. Make them proud. You know, most people have five good friends over a lifetime. Have y'all heard this? These people have five good friends and maybe two or three that you can really count on when they go. Have a flat tire in the midnight hour and call your friends on Facebook or Instagram. Girl, I'm over here with a flat tire. Girl, I'll pray for you. I will pray for you that you find somebody to help you with your flat tire. You'll find out who your friends are. Love and respect these people at all times. They might not agree with what you want to do. They might not always see you face to face, but be respectful. That'll go a long way for you. E, we're getting there. E. This is something else I've done. Encourage somebody every day. Can the young people help me out on that? I don't want to sound like an old guy, but it seems like we're losing that as far as encouragement goes. There's daily opportunities to encourage someone. For one, you can smile. Hey, how about we try that one? Just smile. Oh, you got a beautiful smile, the young lady right there. Beautiful smile. A compliment someone. Let somebody move in front of you. There are multiple ways to be kind. When you give, it shall be given unto you. Press down, shake it together, and run it over. S. Savor the moment. Can we tell them to savor the moment? I can't be the only one that says, these are great days. Young people, they are great days. But in life, it'll be more regular days than days like this. I'm telling you, learn to put that in your spirit. I've had probably one of the best weeks I've ever had in my life. Got a PhD on Tuesday. I got a Presidential Achievement Award, which is one of the highest honors for an American. Yeah, I did. Me? What? From D.C.? What? Man, I am honored. That is a big deal. I savored the moment, but this is a great moment. You savor the moment in your life. I put down on this one. I want to read this. I'm almost done. Most people graduate from high school, start grinding on a job. That's what I'm going to call it. Go to college, join the military, and rarely take time to look around and smell the roses. You must take time to smell the roses, young people. My wife and I have a quote. I want my wife to raise her hand. Honey, just stand up. I want them to know. I want to make sure they got the right person over there. That's Rashida Hill. It was Rashida Henderson. And I'm thankful to you. We have a quote when we say, today is the best day of my life. That was probably my mom saying, hey man, your son over there. Because I realized there's some regular days out there that need to be my best days. And I'm telling the adults as well. When I step out for 38 years and I was a teacher or a principal, it was some tough days. I can tell you. But every day was the best day of my life. I'm going to recite it. Scripture says, but they that wait upon the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings as eagles. Your eagles, you need to remember this. You got to remember this. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not faint. We pray that spirit on you, because you got a long way to go. That sounds like that sounds discouraging, but it's really, it's awesome. Because it's saying you're young and you ought to be able to jump over troops. You ought to be able to lead. And you ought to be able to make it happen. I just want to encourage you. I got a little song at the end. Would y'all mind if I sing one of those songs for you? No, I need a couple of fans to act like they're kind of excited. I don't think this has ever been done where a person sings a short song. But I want it to be memorable, and that's what I've asked God for. I really need y'all to remember one thing. Del City High School was the perfect place for me. I could strive in academics, and my spirit was set free. I'm a high-flying eagle, and I've got the victory, yeah. I thank God. Del City High School, help me out. I thank God for Del City High School, yeah, yeah. I thank God for Del City High School. Y'all be blessed.
At this time, it is my privilege to introduce some outstanding young men and women. The 17 valedictorians from the class 2023. These students have maintained a 4.0 or higher grade point average during their high school years. We calculate valedictorian status at the end of the third 9 weeks of the senior year. Would each valedictorian please stand as I call your name and face your parents in the audience? Parents, we would also ask that you would also stand and be recognized as well. Number one in the class of 2023 is Jada Maslin. Grade point average of 4.42. We're not graduating quite yet. We're getting there. Grade point average of 4.42. Jada's parents are Francia Joseph and Ralph Smith. Jada plans to attend Rose State, then the University of Oklahoma to major in accounting. Jalen Wiley. Grade point average, 4.31. Jalen's parents are Shanidra and Herman Wiley. Jalen plans to attend Oklahoma City University and major in business and finance. Christabel Sam. Grade point average, 4.30. Christabel's parents are John and Naomi Sam. Christabel plans to attend Rose State, then the University of Oklahoma to major in pharmacy. Shane Jordan. Grade point average, 4.28. Shane's parents are Scott and Amber Morales Jordan. Shane plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and major in environmental engineering. Kylie Brown. Grade point average, 4.23. Kylie's parents are Charcetta Brown and the late Eric Brown. Kylie plans to attend Langston University and is currently undecided on the major. Michaela McGee. Grade point average, 4.23. Michaela's parents are Heather Phillips and Ron McGee. Michaela plans to attend Oklahoma State University and is currently undecided on a major. Kirsten Thomas. Grade point average, 4.21. Kirsten's parents are Rhonda Thomas and the late Joseph Thomas. Kirsten plans to attend Rose State College and major in general business and business management. Jada Christie. Grade point average, 4.19. Jada's parents are Giovanna and James Christie. Jada plans to attend University of Oklahoma and major in accounting and finance. Alexis Warchow. Grade point average, 4.16. Alexis's parents are Maria Warchow and Jason Warchow. Alexis plans to attend the University of Central Oklahoma and major in music education. Cadence Reisinger. Grade point average, 4.13. Cadence's parents are John and Rebecca Reisinger. Cadence plans to attend the University of Central Oklahoma and major in history education. DeJuan Hawkins Jr. Grade point average, 4.09. DeJuan's parents are Shalana Davenport and DeJuan Hawkins Sr. DeJuan plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and major in exercise science. Dustin Tooker. Grade point average, 4.07. Dustin's parents are Dustin and Kelly Tooker. Gideon Okutu. Grade point average, 4.05. Gideon's parents are Emmanuel and Doris Okutu. Gideon plans to attend the University of Oklahoma and major in mechanical engineering. Reagan Jaime. Grade point average, 4.04. Reagan's parents are David and Christy Jaime. Reagan plans to attend Rose State and major in business. Alicia Kinnicka. Grade point average, 4.04. Alicia's parents are Andrea and Keith Kinnicka. And Alicia plans to attend Rose State College and major in general business. Anaya Carter. Grade point average, 4.03. Anaya's parents are Crystal Carter and Artis Sims. Anaya plans to attend Oklahoma State University and major in kinesiology. Trinity Bibb. Grade point average, 4.0. Trinity's parents are Tim and Stephanie Bibb. Trinity plans to attend Rose State College and major in education. One more round of applause for these outstanding students and their parents. Three of our valedictorians will now present our traditional commencement address over the past, the present, and the future. Jalen Wiley will speak about the past. Jada Maslin will speak about the present. Shane Jordan will speak about the future. Following the valedictorian, the superintendent of Middell Schools, Dr. Rick Cobb, will be our next speaker. May I present to you Jalen Wiley.
Class of 2023, families, friends, faculty, and staff. We made it. First, I want to thank my family, especially my mom and dad, for their constant love, guidance, and support. They have made everything possible for me, so thank you. As we gather here today to celebrate our graduation, I can't help but reflect back to the past, starting from pre-K, where we first learned how to count and socialize with others. At this very moment in our lives, we didn't know what we were set up for. It was all butterflies and roses back then. And also we had everyone's favorite thing to do, nap time. Fast forward to elementary school, when our outfits were absolutely atrocious, but back then thought otherwise. Also, when we were forced to walk in a single file line like we were in the military. This is the stage where we learn how to read, write, do math, and learn about science from Bill Nye. The memories go on and on. For me, recess is undefeated. Moments such as playing basketball like in Game 7 NBA Finals, and two-hand touch football is wild. The only bad thing about playing football were the stickers. They hurt. Nothing hurts more than getting your fingers caught in the wheels of a scooter in gym class. Also, the Halloween parties, heads down, 7-Up, and the book fairs can't be forgotten. During this time, we couldn't wait to grow up. We were tired of being kids because of the repercussions that came with it. We wanted to have that freedom to do and get what we wanted. But in reality, being a little kid is amazing. You just get to enjoy life carefree with no problems or responsibilities. It's probably the happiest phase of our lives. Elementary school, you will be missed. Now to middle school, where we're excited about lockers we barely use. This was the chapter where we really dove into our passions and interests. We joined clubs, sports teams, and other extracurricular activities. Unfortunately, this was also the chapter of algebra and essays. There were a lot of fun moments these 3 years, like Wildwick events, Black Light parties, and most importantly, dodgeball Fridays in PE class. I can still hear the mirror calls from Coach Barry to this day. Riding the bus wasn't the best though. Not only did I have to wake up earlier, it would also come at different times in the morning to be last to pick us up after school. Outside of that, it was always good laughs. Plus, we had a road bump that always got us out of our seats, hitting our heads on the roof. Middle school was definitely a time of transition. We went from learning the core subjects from one or two teachers to learning multiple subjects selected by several different teachers. And just like that, high school. The past 4 years in particular have been a time of growth, learning, and transformation for all of us. We went from teenagers to young adults. We have also made memories, formed lasting friendships, and worked hard to achieve our goals. Each of us has a unique journey, but there are some common themes that we can all relate to. For one, we have all faced obstacles along the way. Perhaps it was a difficult class or a personal struggle that made it hard to stay on track. March 11th, 2020, fourth hour math class. That is the day and where I was when I got checked out of school due to the coronavirus. It happened during our freshman year and introduced us to Canvas AB schedule sophomore year. We didn't know how severe this pandemic would be. Although it gave us the spring break of a lifetime, we would never want something to happen like that. But we persevered, we found strength in ourselves and each other, and we emerged stronger as a result. We have also experienced moments of joy and celebration. Maybe it was getting an A on a test, we thought we failed, or winning a really important game. I know for me, it's our basketball team in the state this year. The way we ran on a track during preseason, you would have thought we were a track team. Being out there will really make you rethink life. But at least it all paid off. These moments of triumph are worth celebrating, and they remind us of our potential and what we can accomplish when we put our minds to it. I want to thank Coach Hatchett and the rest of the coaching staff for their support and just overall experience these past 4 years. And then there are moments of growth and self-discovery. Maybe we're trying something new or pushing ourselves out of our comfort zones. Those experiences help us learn about ourselves, our values, and what we want out of life. But most importantly, the past has brought us to this moment. It has shaped us into the individuals we are today, and has prepared us for what's to come. We are now armed with knowledge, skills, and confidence to pursue our passions and live fulfilling lives. After more than a decade of learning, here we are. So as we prepare to leave this chapter of our lives behind, let's take a moment to appreciate the past. Let's honor the obstacles we overcome, the triumphs we celebrated, and the growth we've experienced. Let's carry those lessons with us as we move forward and use them to guide us on our journeys. Next, I would like to introduce Jada Madison and talk about the present.
At this point in our lives, we make one of the biggest decisions we will ever make. For some, the answer to what's next is simple, already thought out years in advance. For others, they're simply letting the tides of life carry them. The rest falls somewhere in between, attempting to piece together a future that we'll be proud of with the uncertainty of what comes next. That uncertainty is a blessing in disguise. It shows us that our path is never concrete, never absolute. We are afforded the opportunity to choose, and that is one of the great, most empowering things to have. Our actions in the next few months and in the coming years will affect the trajectories of our lives. We cannot let the pressure dissuade us from pursuing what we truly want from life. We are the creators of our own fortune, and it is up to us to sow the seeds now so we can reap the bounty of success later in life. No matter what path you choose, it is important to spend each moment pushing forward. You may stumble, you may falter, you may even fall. No matter what, you have to pick yourself up and keep moving. You can't let the trials and tribulations of life prevent you from reaching your potential. You have to spend each day fighting to achieve your dreams and aspirations. You have to give every day your all, as much or as little as that is. That drive is essential because as the next generation, we get to decide our impact on the future of mankind. We are entering a world that is unapologetically unforgiving, a world that wishes to tear us down. But it is upon us to challenge not only ourselves, but the predisposition that our generation will fail. It is up to us to right the wrongs of those before us and to create a world where those that come after us can not only survive, but thrive. This daunting task has been given to us without our input or opinion, but it is a task we have nevertheless. Just always remember that as small as your influence may seem, every single action you make affects you, your community, and your world. Every decision has a consequence, whether that be positive or negative. It's up to you to decide what your impact will be. Each and every one of us has the qualities necessary to make a difference. The only question is, will you? Now I would like to introduce Superintendent Dr. Kyle.
Thank you, Shane. And just before I start, I want to say that I'm not one of the people that would expect your generation to fail. I expect your generation is going to be the best one this country's ever seen. So, with that, good afternoon. Thank you for coming out to celebrate all these amazing graduates. Parents, friends, faculty, and administrators, on behalf of the Middell Board of Education, I want to thank you for supporting these students all the way through elementary school, middle school, and now high school. I also want to give special thanks to F&B Community Bank. Each graduate will receive a dollar coin, courtesy of F&B, when they cross the stage today. Eagles, congratulations, you did it. I hope that today is memorable for you, and I'm certain your journey here has been full of moments you'll never forget. I don't know what are your highlights at this point in your life. I just hope that when you come back to reconnect in the coming years, you will have built upon them and that you'll have even greater accomplishments. Martin Luther King Jr. said life's most persistent and urgent question is, what are you doing for others? Well, what are you doing for others? Many of you are already making adult decisions. You're stepping into careers, military service, higher education, and even families of your own. You want to be successful, you want to be happy, but you also want to be fulfilled. And you get that through service to others, having a purpose beyond what is immediately in front of you. It's the little things like simple kindness when people around you are struggling. It's having empathy, which is the understanding that others may be dealing with circumstances that you can't see and that don't affect you, but caring anyway. Most importantly, it's the intentional drive to find things, to find ways to lift the people around you. Maybe it's a neighbor, maybe it's the entire community, or the state, or even the nation. Whatever you do, wherever you go from here, your education has prepared you for your personal accomplishments, but with space to make room for others. Along with the Middell Board of Education and our entire community, I'm excited to see where you go from here. Congratulations, class of 2023.
This is the moment you've been waiting for.
Dr. Cobb, President Kirk, members of the Board of Education, I certify that these seniors have met the requirements of the Oklahoma State Department of Education and the Middle Board of Education and may receive their diplomas. Will the class officers led by President Latrell Crump and the valedictorians led by Jaya Massman please come forward to receive their diplomas.
Latrell Montez Crump.
Jayla Michelle Master.
Marissa Marie Polk.
Jalen Marquise Wiley.
State champion.
Fatima Duran Blanco.
Christabel Achan Sayer.
Cadence Nicole Reisinger.
Shane Michael Jordan.
Destiny Nicole Mays.
Kylie Danae Brown.
Alexia Rayanne Velez.
Jada Ryan Christie.
Damian Lamont Simmons Jr.
Michaela Nicole McGee.
Dakota Lynn Kelton.
Kirsten Paige Thomas.
Deja Lene Williams.
Alexis Marissa Warchow.
Aaron Anise Kinnica.
Dewan Eugene Hopkins Jr.
Natalie Angela Madison.
Dustin Thomas Tooker.
Sydney Ray McMillan.
Gideon Tay Okutu.
Rihanna Trine Burns.
Reagan Jaime.
Maria Aguayo Ariano De Jesus.
Alicia Renee Kinnicutt.
Cyrus Keith Adams.
Anaya Carter.
Prentice Allen Jr.
Trinity Noelle Bibb.
Allison Marie Bella.
Mahogany Faith Martin.
Kimberly Denise Arroyo.
Michael Edward Mayers.
Angel Nadea Duchesne.
Carlos Enrique Martinez.
Cameron Hayden Bush.
Honesty KG Malone.
Jason Todd Burns Jr.
Kwali Jamil Maciel.
Carly Janae Burt.
State champ, Jamari Deshaun McAllister.
Ashton Lashay Brown.
Tango Lee McCulley Jr.
Addison James Briggs.
Ricky Marcellus McCullough.
Ronald Bennett IV.
Caroline Maxine McKnight.
Malia L.A. Bird.
Keyshawn Jarrell Meadows.
Micaiah Elay Bills.
Ethan Franklin Mesna.
Markel Deshaun Boyle.
Jesse Wayne Meyer.
Landon Robert Bolton, or Barton.
Trinity Jade Mears.
Omar DeMarco Brown.
Carmelo Tidon Mitchell.
Josiah Hugh Burris.
Ayula Nicole Morana.
Remington Bell Bingham.
Rowan Joshua Moreau.
Caitlin Anne-Marie Bishop.
Mason Martin Muller.
Mary Lee Breeden.
Hayden Gabriel Mullen.
Julian Bevian Guevara.
Carnell Jared Neal.
Demarion Jaquay Bradford.
Andre Jose Negretti.
Patricia Cheyenne Bishop.
Levi James Negretti.
Haley Danielle Bishop.
Nicola Ray Nelson.
Miranda Ruby Armendariz.
Sasha Anne Marie Nelson.
Mary Ann.
Hope McKenzie Neal.
Brianna McKay Burnett.
Bernicia Talea Nelson.
Micaiah Marie Claiborne.
Nicholas Cheaton Wigg.
Blessy Calabroso.
Bao Nguyen.
Jesus Castillo Bustamante.
Davion Norman.
Ian Ceballos Hernandez.
Vanessa Nortway.
Sine Cordette Clayton.
Akaya Sarai Norwood.
Liberty Dawn Clement.
Derek O'Neill.
Javon Otieno Cleophas.
Kareem Ortegoza.
Kira Don Cole. Coberly.
Jake Devine Owens.
Matthew Benjamin Coberly.
Tyreek Leroy Ali.
Robert Brock Campbell.
Ariel Marielle Pointer.
Alexis Danae Colbert Young.
Denija Rashay Payne.
Janiyah Renee Cooper.
Casey Renee Pegler.
David LaJean Cooper.
Foamy Nicole Petro.
Taylor Raphael Cooper.
Robert Pittman.
Akayla Marie Cooper.
Kevlin Sean Perry.
Connor James Cook.
Amaya Michelle Harris.
Quentin Terrell Couch.
Alyssa Danae Pope.
Destiny Ann Crane.
Eric Polito.
Christopher Diaz Martinez.
Hayden Payne Rambosi.
Cameron James Delgado.
Taylor Jane Reeves.
JJ Jean Dude.
Amani D. Rice.
Dakota Heath Edwards.
Charles Harlan Rourke.
Glamera Dora Davis.
Cameron Deshaun Robinson.
Daviantria Charmaine Ellis.
Lanice Danielle Robinson.
Christian Kaja Elam.
Journey Jalea Vetta Russell.
Chastity Daystar Doolin.
Shannon Dorshawn Rowland.
Isabel Estrada.
Brooklyn Nicole Rose.
Melanie Evans.
Devin Allen Mitchell.
Layla Falana.
Jerome Vincent Simon.
Sydney Faye Fanning.
Randy Lee Sarton II.
Ruby Lynn Fenwick.
Laramie Don Savage.
Jaden Lamont Foreman Felix, state champ.
David Joshua Scott.
Kanigel Kai Malik Thomas.
Giselle T. Scott.
Kamari Samir Frederick.
Laquan Malik Scruggs.
Damian A. Graham.
James Shawnee.
Colin Theopolis Gaines.
Cedric Dallas Shannon Jr.
Daniel Scott Garza.
Hannah Janelle Sharp.
Marissa Renee Flores.
Timothy Slater.
Kylie Anise Gentry.
Mallory Renee Slayman.
Jasmine Moye Goff.
Melanie Slayman.
Nayeli Brie Gomez Mora.
Cody Lynn Smith.
Kayla Marie Grimm.
Zaria Smith.
Brianna Lynn Gerhardt.
State champion, Nikaylin Godwin.
Ezekiel Christopher Gomez.
Anaya Imani Marie Shell.
Ayana Aliyah Gonzalez.
Heaven Amari Marie Stinnett.
Carla Elizabeth Gonzalez.
State champion, Brandon Mackay Garrison.
Alexis Guadalupe Ramajo Pina.
Ashley Jasmine Solis.
Joshua Stephen Green.
Clarissa Danielle Sparks.
State champion Percy Donovan Eugene Green.
Risa Shirley Colleen Spitz.
William Douglas Gooseby.
Joseph Frederick St. John.
Cassandra Jessica Ann Genovese.
Lashante Shanice Stanford.
Trayvon R. Johnson.
Corey Don Stephanie Jr.
Marquise and Juan Lamar Stell.
Starla Sumner.
Luke Tia.
Rayvon Swindle.
Diogene Latrice Gunter.
Jalen Sweet.
Molly Ann Helens.
Two Train.
John Garrett Hampton.
Leia Teal.
Amari Francis Thomas.
Janae LeMay Thompson.
Nakaya Tanae Mahmood.
Shelijah Tamar Thompson.
Kennedy Carrie Fong.
Nishala Nicole King.
Sylvia Diane Harvey.
Juan Pablo Trujillo.
Atazion Laquan Ashley.
Gabriel Tapia.
Lauren Alyssa Hill.
Adriana Danielle Urioski.
Juanita Michelle Henderson.
Cameron Shay Harrison.
Cameron Mikkel Hogan.
Mateo Vasquez.
Michelle Antoinette Feliciano Serrano.
Zachary Valdez.
Joquan, the great one, Howard.
Logan Leroy Heineken.
Louis Jose Humphreys.
Kelsey Ann Van Baldwin.
Jada Lazan Blaze.
Zakinzie Trinity Bond.
Mariah Renee Hooks.
Arlessa Eva Marie Houston.
Anaya Sinjane Hudson.
Aisling Aaliyah K. Holmes.
Stanley Dwayne Johnson.
State champion Deshaun Devon Long.
Penelope Bell Hyman.
Morgan Lewis.
Evan Josue Johnson.
Jalen Dwayne Ivy.
Jay Samaya Paxton.
Terrence Dwayne Holly.
Keelan Erlena King.
Janae Martin.
Naima Lee.
Daisy Alicia Leos.
Julian Miguel Lopez.
Kaylee Don Jones.
Elijah Eugene Watson.
Angelina and Marie Lucio.
Leah Camille Taylor.
Taya Nicole Lewis.
Lorraine Marie Williams.
State champion Demaryius Beeley.
Rizana Maria Walton.
Jared Marquis Van.
Destiny Wright. Mariah Darlene Bain. Josiah Marquita Wittenberg.
Serenity Marie Deshae White.
Genesis Nevea Casey.
Sienna Renee Lowry. Annika Danielle Wathen. Charles Arthur Wall. Khalil Amir Williams.
Marion Walton.
Isaac Leon Pugh.
Makai Williams.
Keyshawn Wiley.
Hunter Lee Monroe.
Before the alma mater, I would like to ask our faculty to line up for the recessional. Our Del Airs will now come forward and lead the singing of the Del City High School alma mater. Senior class 2023, in preparation of the singing of the alma mater, will you rise and move your tassel from the right to the left? As graduates of Del City High School, go be great.
Thank you. Commencement.